Hello and welcome to the beautiful ancient city of Ordensur, a city perhaps best known as the birthplace of Hans Christian Andersen, the world-famous author of poems and children's fairy tales. But for the ninth consecutive year, Ordensur is the home of the Yonex Denmark Open, presented this year by Danisa. It is one of the oldest tournaments in the sport of badminton, and it's also the ninth event on the 12 tournament MetLife BWF World Superseries. There, the full list of all 12 tournaments. But it's not only the ninth event of the year, it's also one of the five premier events, an even higher tier of tournament within the Superseries. And of course, at the end of the year, the Superseries finals. The top eight players and pairs in each of the five disciplines will qualify for the Superseries finals. And the destination is once again Dubai for those end of year championships. Well, five matches for you this afternoon, and we're going to start with men's singles and the two-time former champion Lee Chong Wei of Malaysia up against Wei Nan of Hong Kong. Then we turn to women's singles and another former champion, the current world number one, Saina Nehwal of India, up against Minatsu Mitani of Japan. Then we're back to men's singles and the young Dane, Victor Axelsen. He's already been in three Super Series tournament finals this year. He's up against last year's beaten finalist Sung Wan Ho of Korea. Then we've got men's doubles and the qualifiers, Liu Cheng and Liu Kai, up against the reigning and two-time world champions, Mohamed Hassan and Hendra Setiawan. Then we finish with mixed doubles and the three-time former winners of this Denmark Open, the home players, Joachim Fischer-Nielsen and Christina Pedersen. They're up against the qualifiers, Kazuno and Kurihara of Japan. So a great lineup for you this afternoon. It really is a terrific lineup. We've got all the world's best players here. Of course, the Premier Super Series status means that all the world's best converge in Denmark for battling it out for the title. Now, as I say, it is part of the Super Series, and of course, as part of the Super Series, that race to Dubai, the Super Series finals is on. Lee Chong Wei, the unseeded player, former world number one and former champion here, up against Wei Nan. There is Wei Nan, the man from Hong Kong, only making his second appearance here at the Denmark Open.
From Malaysia, Lee Chong Wei.
Lee Chong Wei, he will get a very warm reception here from the fans in Ordensur. He's hugely popular all over the world. The former world number one. He's been in four finals here at the Denmark Open. He's won the title twice, the first 10 years ago in 2005, and again won the title in 2012. I'm Jill Clark, delighted to say that I'm sitting beside the former head coach of the Denmark team, Steen Pedersen, and it really has been a terrific tournament so far, and it's a great lineup for today's matches.
Yeah, really exciting and really good matches to look forward here on a Thursday afternoon in Denmark.
Yes, it's always a tournament that the players like to play. The arena here is very intimate, the crowd very close, as you can see. And I was talking about the destination Dubai, and there's the standings at the moment, the rankings. And of course, this is after the first eight tournaments. The last tournament prior to this Denmark Open, the Korean Open, was won by Chen Long. No wonder he's the number one. That was his fourth Super Series title of the year. Semi-finalist in Korea, Kento Momoto. Well, he's number two, and incidentally, the top two have won six of the eight Super Series tournaments so far this year. The two Danes swapping places, Victor Axelsen going up to number three because poor old Jan Jorgensen wasn't able to play in the last two Super Series events due to illness. To remind you, it will only be the top eight that qualify for the Destination Dubai Super Series finals. So these two players, vastly experienced in world terms, both in their 30s. This man, Lee Chong Wei, will turn 33 later this month. Now, this is actually the top quarter of the draw. And as you can see, look at the strength in that, because the number eight seed, Kashyap Parupalli, beaten in the first round by Lee Chong Wei. and should mention should be made of the qualifier, Emil Holst. Didn't he give Wei Nan a battle yesterday in the first round? Of course, the defending champion, Chen Long, the number one seed. He is the world champion, and rightly so, the world number one. So it promises to be a very tough quarter in this section of the draw. Three consecutive finals this man was in. 2011, 12 and 13. Two-time former champion, who's 25 in the world ranking at the moment. He's only got seven tournaments towards that world ranking. Three finals this year from six tournaments played. His win-loss record for the year translating into that. And of course, as I was mentioning, his first round match, he defeated the number eight seed, Kashyap Parupalli. Two straight games in 47 minutes. So his opponent, Wei Nan, 31-year-old, born in Fuzhou, in Fujian province, which is where, of course, we play the China Premier Super Series event, the second-to-last Super Series event of the year. He's been in a couple of semi-finals this year, but not at Super Series level. China Masters Grand Prix Gold and the Chinese Taipei Grand Prix Gold. And as I was saying, the qualifier, Emil Holst, gave him a real run for his money in yesterday's first round encounter. Well, this will be the second meeting between these two players. The first time they met, the match was won by the former world number one, Li Chong Wei, in two straight games. That was in the first round of the Singapore Super Series last year. 2014 Singapore Super Series. Two straight games, as you can see. So Li Chong Wei, well, he's always enjoyed playing here in Denmark. Henrik Boas and Alan Potter are court officials for this match. But I was reading an article about how the demons, because of course it was at the World Championships last year in Copenhagen where this man was found to have violated one of the doping issues and therefore was out of the game for 8 months. I think there's an awful lot of fans very happy to see him back. He's a very exciting, dynamic player to watch. And when you see him play, it really is quite difficult to believe he's about to turn 33 years of age, because he's still one of the fastest players in world badminton.
He seems as quick as ever.
On my right, Wei Nan, Hong Kong, China. On my left, Li Chong Wei, Malaysia. Li Chong Wei to serve.
So the former champion, the former world number one, Li Chong Wei, getting this second round match underway. Now this man, Steen, Wei Nan, I always think looks very laid back on court.
Yeah.
In between rallies, he's always looks very calm, and yet he's a very fine player.
And he's actually able to change playing styles, because I can remember watching him, I think it was against Kento Momota, but I'm not really sure, where I totally wrote him off after the first game and said, I don't think he's got anything to come back with here. And I thought he was incapable of playing an attacking style, but suddenly he changed it around and attacked, because that was what was needed at that time.
Two,
excellent smash
one.
Here. Just sort of emphasize it a little bit.
Yeah. That wasn't in the first round of this tournament last year, was it? Because he lost to Kento Momota in three games.
He might have lost, but he came back, and I thought he would be whitewashed after some of the first game.
Yeah, well taken. Well, of course, there's going to be an awful lot of people wanting to see whether Li Chong Wei has managed to restore his confidence and his self-belief, because in Korea, the last Super Series event prior to this, he lost in the first round of the qualifying to the 2013 World Junior Champion.
Yeah, so even though it says seven tournaments on his world ranking, it is practically six tournaments because he got so few points from that Korean Open tournament.
And he's still 25 in the world.
Yeah. So we're going to see him move up when he's played.
His
three or four more tournaments.
Yeah. Oh, that's nice. Missed it. You know, Steen, when I talk about, you know, whether Li Chong Wei has got his self-confidence back, it seems such an extraordinary thing to say from a player that was world number one for so long. He's been in 88 career tournament finals, winning 57 of them. He's been in 56 Super Series tournament finals. You know, just try and explain to us, and explain to me, because I'm a bit confused by it too. How can I doubt his self-confidence? How can he doubt his self-confidence when you've been such a remarkable player?
Many people wonder why that happens, but it's I think it's the nature of being a top sportsman, whether it's a male or female sportler. Self-confidence is a very fragile thing, and it's also fragile with these players here, even though they're used to winning. It's not like they're not nervous on court and so on. And we can also see matches when they're about to achieve great results, suddenly nerves kick in. Why do they do that?
Yeah.
They must be so confident. But I think the answer is that it's a very, very fragile thing, because you really want to live up to the people's expectations to you and your own goals that you work so hard for day in and day out.
Yeah.
Six.
Oh, what a return of serve. Tight spinning net shot from Wei Nan.
When you're coming back from being away from tournament play for a number of months, whether it's because of injury or something else, I mean, things are not going exactly the same as just before you sort of got your break. You're going to make more mistakes, and probably you're going to lose more points at practice and so on. And everything affects your self-confidence. So the people around him need to do a really, really hard job of reinforcing him and emphasizing what he's doing well and sort of proving to him that he's still really, really good.
Yeah. Oh, of course he is. He's recently been in the final of the World Championships. And it's remarkable in sport that, you know, they always say you're only as good as your last result. And that annoys me to a certain extent, because, you know, you can't take away... He hasn't become a bad player. He's still a fabulous player. Why are people doubting him? Human nature, I suppose.
And I think we see some similarities, at least in my country, in Denmark, regarding some of the tennis players, that even if they achieve at a very, very high level, then the fans, the supporters, they want them to achieve at an even higher level.
Yeah.
And that's just such a pressure to cope with, because I mean, there are other players wanting to win as well and working hard every day.
Service over.
Oh, the very elevation on that jump smash.
Dry smash. Really, really dry.
Never beyond a quarter final in a Super Series event, yeah. Wei Nan.
And since there's a Demon Cup, only lost to two players, Kento Momota and Chen Long. And those two, I rate them among the five best players in the world. So, at least he's off to a good start here. Been playing well, been scoring his own points. And I think that's really important when you play Li Chongwei, that you actually feel that you can score points against him, because he's normally so good in the defense, so quick on his feet.
Well, that is phenomenal smash. We're looking straight down that line, and that was perfect. We have, of course, got the challenge system here on this court. Hawkeye can adjudicate if necessary. Oh, he simply took that too late at the net, Li Chongwei. Look at this.
Yeah.
It's just 6 inches off the floor. You can't afford to do that. It's no wonder that got pounced upon.
Dia punya weapon memang bagus hari ini. Mesti mau exit. Depannya kebanyakan fokus depan lebih banyak ininya. Jangan selalunya buka. Belakangnya tak ada chance attack tak apa, ada chance turun dulu sabar. Tapi depannya fokusnya lebih banyak.
Sorry.
How's your bahasa?
not sufficient to understand what Hendrawan is saying, but hopefully our international viewers can can understand what is being discussed here in the interval. He's got a glimpse of the Hong Kong coach. I think the last thing that Hong Kong has improved since he took up the job.
Oh, yes. Well, exactly what you were talking about right at the start of this match. Suddenly, he can play the attacking game
exactly.
When he needs to, Wei Nan.
And it's a very, very short pre-shot or the swing that he's got on that smash, which makes it really, really hard to predict where it's going to land. Look at that. Once again, excellent. And he's nowhere near it, Chong Wei. And that's, of course, not... It's not a self-confidence booster.
No.
Seeing the opponent killing smashes on the sideline.
So a 6-point advantage to Wei Nan.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. What's your advice to a player if they appear to be lacking self-confidence? Is it go back to the basics and concentrate doing the basics very well? Take the shuttle early?
Yeah.
You know, don't necessarily aim for the lines. Just make sure when you've got the opportunity to attack, you make that attack count.
Yeah, and especially the attacking side is important. Don't go for the win on the first attacking shot. Build it up and as you say, sort of take... The most risky shots away from your game for a while, but you need to execute them again later on, because otherwise you won't be able to play at the level that you expect to play. I mean, if you only play 90%, you're gonna lose to a lot of players that you normally beat in the percentages in between the 90 and hundreds.
Mm.
So in some ways you gotta go back to the basics for a number of rallies, and then hopefully you can get a little bit more confidence and come back and try one of the more difficult shots or solutions later on.
Missed it.
Yeah.
10-14.
But I think that's actually okay for Wei Nan that he misses some, because I'd rather have that he misses one and kills three than he gets Li Chongwei going in the defense.
Pushed it long. Yeah. And it's very interesting to hear you say that, because, you know, so many coaches in my experience, I know I'm going back many, many years to when I was a player, but, you know, there was always this, Jill, if you're going for the winner, you're making an error, and you shouldn't be making errors at this stage. Yeah. And I like to have that expressive style of play. I like to be trying to do the right thing.
Yeah, and the same coaches, if it were a winner, they would praise you and say, whoa, that was brilliant play. Mm. So there's also this that... Is that called good?
No, it was just wide.
There's also the scare in it that Li Chongwei here, he knows that if he plays too short or if he leaves Wei Nan too much time, he's going to attack and it's going to be qualified, the attack that's coming.
Yeah.
Of course, if it's three losers and one winner, then we have a problem.
Oh. Well, that was a lovely net shot because it got deflected by the net cord. Yeah, made it difficult for Li Chongwei. Had to readjust his shot.
16-11.
Here's Hendra one.
Yeah, looking a little bit worried.
Mm.
And I don't mind because, I can understand him because in some ways it's a little bit of a comeback tournament for Chongwei. It's a small, small comeback because the result in Korea was so extraordinary. I don't think he's perhaps ever lost the first round in a qualification.
No. Oh, that's brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Not only that, when you think about the fact that up until the Indonesia Premier Super Series last year, Li Chongwei had been in at least the semi-final of 36 consecutive Super Series tournaments.
Yeah.
So to lose in a first round of a qualifying, well, he openly talked about the fact it was his worst result ever.
Yeah. But of course, it's also, in some ways, it's also time to take a look at his game and see how is it actually. In the smash we saw here from 17-11 to 18-11, comes on a return that's simply not the good quality that he needs to play with.
Well, that is something that I thought, and I don't know your feelings at the World Championships in the final. I've always thought of Li Chongwei and his net play and his speed to the net as virtually second to none. Mm. Some may argue that Lin Dan equally as quick and equally as aggressive and off-putting to your opponent from the front of the court. And I felt either he was slightly hesitant, but I felt he wasn't taking it as early as he used to.
And I think that might be due to confidence issues.
Oh, my goodness. Well, ambitious shot to try.
But I think what we're seeing here from 18-11 to 18-15 is Wei Nan overdoing it a little bit, feeling that he needs to do a bit more than what's actually necessary. He's been the better player so far in the first game.
This is a good comeback from the former world number one, Li Chongwei. Just 2 points the deficit now. Off the frame of Li Chongwei, and the shuttle bounced back over the net. Look at this. But look how late he's taken that. Well, that's extraordinary, isn't it?
Always a borderline decision in these situations, whether it should be called a fault or not.
Now, just explain to people the exact ruling on that.
You're allowed to, you cannot prevent your opponent from executing his shot, but you're allowed to cover your face.
Mm. Oh, well taken. Yeah. Well taken. Yeah.
19-17.
He's really good at that, Wei Nan. Killing it in his forehand side, that's not easy. It's a really tricky shot. Most players are more confident executing a shot like that from their backhand side. Again.
Well, the fault is called on Wei Nan, taking the shuttle before it had crossed over the net. I wouldn't mind seeing that again. Here we go. Oh, we won't see from this angle. Oh. Was he called for touching the net?
No.
It was the shuttle, wasn't it?
Yeah,
here we go.
So.
Yeah,
it's over.
That's a great call by the umpire there.
Serve's over.
So game point opportunities for Wei Nan. Two of them to be precise. Great anticipation from Wei Nan to the cross-court smash from Li Chong Wei. And with that wonderful defensive shot, he takes the opening game, 21-18. Look at the anticipation first from Li Chong Wei. And then he hesitated, obviously thought it was going to go wide. But look at the great defense there from Wei Nan. That is remarkable. Look at that movement. Fabulous. What a way to close out the opening game.
Kalau bola bawah sekali-sekali berani net lagi. Terus kalau bola bawah always lift, dia sudah memang tunggu. Apa dia sometimes dia tap sekali-sekali. Kalau tak try berani net lagi dia pun mulai ragu-ragu. Terus liftnya atau apa banyak cross supaya dia lari sedikit. Terus kalau senang macam ini ya, ininya beda wah tak mau ah. Lari cross lari lagi. Itu kalau dia lari dia angle-nya tak ada. Jadi kalau dia tunggu macam ini itu coba tukar game sedikit. Sampai bagi jauh tak apa. Sabar. Chong Wei pun tak banyak lari. Tukar. Terus kalau sekarang hari ini dia tengok depannya. Terus liftnya kalau bola bawah sekali-sekali berani net lagi. Terus kalau bola bawah always lift. Dia sudah jadi memang tunggu. Apa dia sampai dia tap sekali. Kalau tak try berani net lagi dia pun mulai lagi.
Well, there was definitely some sort of instruction about cross court, but what he was saying, we're not terribly sure. What we are sure of is that the unseeded Wei Nan is one game to the good.
And the encouraging thing for Chong Wei is, of course, that he sort of got some points towards the end of that game, but the worrying thing was that he didn't create them all by himself necessarily. It was a little bit Wei Nan who got a little bit too eager, and that's a bad quality service. And there's no doubt that he will be questioning himself inside Li Chong Wei. Am I still good enough? Can I still do this? At least some part of him will do that. The there's a bit of the answer.
Yeah, that's the sort of shot and the sort of movement, fast movement, that I'm so used to seeing. But my goodness me, talking of fast shots and fast movement, there from Wei Nan.
Yeah. Let's see if Armin's...
You're right about that overhead. Yeah. It's not a big swing, is it?
No, it's very, very short and very efficient.
Yeah.
I really like it. He's struggling in the defense, Chong Wei, and I think in some ways he's done it ever since he came back. It's not the same wall to play against as it used to be normally before he was banned. It was really, really hard scoring on him. Everything came back. It was so frustrating, but it's not like that anymore.
Well, if there's a little bit of tension,
yeah,
you know, then the reaction time is a bit slower, isn't it?
Exactly. And we also know that to take players from a good junior level to a good senior level, the thing that's the hardest is to actually get the defensive in place and working. Perhaps half a year or so with intensive practice.
Oh, that was nice.
Yeah, that was a good net shot. Good call. That's wide.
Review, please.
So it is the umpire who's asking Hawkeye to make the decision because the line judge was unsighted. Here we go. Let's have a little look ourselves.
No, I think perhaps...
You think that's
actually
out?
Actually, I'd like to change my first impression. I think it's in.
Ah. Well, we've got Hawkeye here, and Hawkeye will tell us for sure. The instant review system. Now, just to remind you, neither player will lose a challenge here because it's the umpire who's asked for the adjudication from Hawkeye. Well, must be tight because Hawkeye taking its time. Well, still they wait. Here we go. It is out, my goodness me, by a whisker.
Yeah, that was a tight decision.
Yeah, that's one of your examples on the defense, isn't it?
And it's not the thing that you should pay attention to is it's not necessarily a hard smash, it's a well-placed smash.
Yeah.
Steep and well-placed.
It's gone wrong. Any difference in the ends here, Steen? Seems pretty well perfect to me, playing conditions.
Yeah, normally it's very, very good playing conditions, but at the qualifying rounds, there were a little bit of discussions that there might be some slight drift coming from the end where Chong Wei is playing towards the end where
we are.
We are, and where Wei Nan are.
Oh, that net shot was going wide. Oh, there we go. Yeah.
That happens when you play Chong Wei. Excellent.
Yeah, look at that agility. Yeah, I told you you'd got fans all over for the world here in Odense. Chanting his name.
Good coverage by Chong Wei there.
And I think that's the first time in the match that he's really pressurized the net.
Yes, he had a good net shot. We saw that before, but apart from that, Wei Nan has dominated the net area, and I don't think Chong Wei can allow him to do that. He needs to take up the challenge.
Oy. Oh, good defense. Oh, that was short, that clear.
Yeah, very clever shot.
Yeah.
Of course, Chong Wei's got quite a heavy strapping on his right knee, and it's always difficult to tell whether it's just a precaution or it's actually bad, but we've seen him struggle in that forehand side in the defense.
Yeah, umpire saying speed up in between rallies, quite right too. Well, that is his persona, really, isn't it?
That's his style. In the first game, when there was a break in between the rallies, he went on like he only had to play the next rally tomorrow. Oh. But he's using his power inside the rallies, and
yeah,
that's a good thing.
And that's another amazing smash. Power and precision.
So the interesting thing is to see what does he have in the bag, Li Chong Wei? What can he do about this? Because it's Wei Nan's match so far. He's conducting the match. So that could be one of the answers to play a little bit more attacking style in order to prevent your opponent from attack, because he hasn't been able to deal with the attack from Wei Nan. He must take a little bit more initiative himself or get his defense working. Perhaps he's playing a little bit too short. I haven't been paying attention to that. That's pretty long. And the smash went into the net. So could be the case. Sometimes if your defense breaks down, the first thing you should think about is, do I have the correct length on my shot? Is my clears and my lifts, are they long enough?
Good judgment. 11-9 interval. So to the mid-game interval with a two-point advantage, Li Chong Wei. Yep, definitely wide of the mark.
Very difficult coaching situation for Luan Jin here, because I'm pretty sure as a coach he feels that this is a good chance for Wei Nan to beat Li Chong Wei, but it's not a given. He needs to play really well still. So you want to encourage your player, but you also want to sort of give him a little bit of advice on what might come from the other side.
Depannya anda tengok waktu dia quality atau apa liftnya bagi tinggi sekali ya, jangan cuma tinggi sekali nih.
He's so quick on his feet on that front court, Wei Nan.
Yeah.
That's well played. Well played by Wei Nan.
It is well played, but I'm looking at that and I'm saying to myself, it's Wei Nan again who's the first at the net. Yes. He's the man that's taking it higher.
Yeah. And I always said it a number of times, I still think that the shot quality from Li Chongwei is not good enough. There's too many weak shots that allows his opponent to get back into the match free of charge. And I think so far it's only been Chen Long and Lin Dan who's been able to punish him, but it's interesting to see if other players have caught up on that, have bettered themselves in the areas that they were not good enough in and are able to challenge Li Chongwei now. Yeah, well played.
I do sense an up in tempo in the movement of Li Chongwei from that opening game.
Yeah. I mean, if I were Hendren, I would try to get Chong Wei to play a little bit away from the net. Not play the backcourt all the time, but play longer drop shots in order to prevent Wei Nan from dominating the net so much.
Well, we've got a challenge here. Smash from Li Chong Wei was called in. Wei Nan begs to differ. Let's have a look at this. Oh no, I thought
very
that
close.
Was in. Very close. Quite difficult to tell from that, isn't it?
Yeah, it's so difficult to tell where the cork actually hits.
Oh, hits the floor. Here we go.
It's out.
Yeah, well, what a great challenge.
Challenge successful. Two challenges remaining. Steps over.
Very important 12, for 13. Wei Nan. 12-13 instead of 14-11 for Chong Wei.
Oh, well, there's a challenge there. Now, I thought that was definitely wide. What did you think? Not quite
really
as certain as me.
No. But look, he's moving away from the net again.
Yes. Yeah,
I think
that's
out.
That's out, surely. Well, we should perhaps say that the Hawkeye system has high-speed cameras, little cameras going down all the lines there, so they're able to slow it down to, what is it? How many frames per second?
200 or something like that.
Yeah, it's phenomenal, isn't it? So they can tell exactly where the shuttle has landed and where the cork has landed.
Please,
oh, here we go.
Technical
in.
Oh,
in.
Challenge unsuccessful.
Two very, very important challenges.
Yeah.
And I think this Chong Wei moving back from the net is a sign that he perhaps has lost a little bit of his speed. Maybe we're not good enough to see it, but he feels it himself, because normally he would just stay there, and if he's played to the baseline, he would just quickly run back and hit a quality shot. And we've seen him also retrieve defensive shots, lying on the floor, looking to see if the opponent was able to retrieve his shot. And then, if he was, then get up and go after it.
Well, it's the moment of truth, isn't it? 14 all. Who's got the courage? Who's got the belief?
Yeah.
That's good disguise. Yeah, it was quick forward,
so
wasn't
quick.
It?
Oh, what a great clear.
That is wonderful. Yeah, and very, very interesting. Did you see Coach Hendrawan behind the Malaysian?
No, I didn't.
Nodding and saying, yep, accept it. That was a great shot by your opponent, and it certainly was, wasn't it?
But Chong Wei is walking around on court the way he normally walks around when he's about to lose a badminton match, with his head down, walking slowly, and that sort of gives away a little bit his emotions, I think.
Mm, and state of mind.
Good catch.
Unbelievable.
There it was.
What a rally. I don't believe it. And that's
it's
gone
long.
What a rally. My goodness me. Net shot. Oh, the desperation defense there. And again there from Wei Nan off his right hip.
16-0.
Well, that perhaps proves your point about the very slight drift coming towards us as we look down on the court. What a rally, though.
In many ways, this is actually pretty much what both players have looked for. I mean, Chong Wei has lost the first game. He must be satisfied he's still in it here in the second. And then Wei Nan has won the first game, and he's still got a good chance of taking this match in two games, in straight games. Very interesting rallies we're up for now. The going gets tough.
Oh, there's going to be a yellow card for time wasting. He's already had the verbal warning. It is fantastic, isn't it?
And he's got such a great touch from quite a bit 16. Below the tape. Look at this.
Yeah.
Dares to play the net on his forehand side.
But did you think that Lee Chong Wei was backing off a little bit too much from the net?
And I don't understand. Why does he play the net back? Because it hasn't worked for him throughout this match. And it's probably not going to work for the rest of the match either. Unless he plays some flat lifts.
Yeah, well, to me, that lift just simply wasn't deep enough.
18-16.
Look where Wei Nan's feet are. Well, difficult to tell from
so
that.
So successful. They've definitely spotted a weakness in that area there. Not a full power smash, little slice in it. It's really hard for Chong Wei to get to that.
So three straight points.
Way too short, that service return. And that's 16. One of the points that I saw the match he played in Japan against Lin Dan, and his service returns, they are, in my opinion, lacking a lot of quality. Way too easy to read for the opponents. No deception on them.
2 points away. The man from Hong Kong from winning this second round encounter.
Choice there. He's high on the net, Chong Wei. Then he can play it.
Exactly. That's short. Yep. Yeah, got what it deserved. Brilliant, absolutely brilliant. His attacking play, the angles of his smashes, the placement of his smashes.
It's been great.
Been fantastic. Look at that. Wonderful. And now two match point opportunities. Yeah, well saved. Well, Lee Chong Wei certainly expecting the shuttle from the backhand. Oh, Wei Nan back to the net. Look how far forward he was. One match point saved. Another one remains.
Oh, that's long.
It's gone long. And the victory to Wei Nan of Hong Kong against the former world number one and the former champion here, Lee Chong Wei. But what a performance from this man. My goodness me, his attacking play was simply brilliant. He took the shuttle early at the front of the court, forced the short lift, and when he was able to play the attacking shots, he hit winner after winner. This is the final rally. Look how late Lee Chong Wei is taking that. Watch as it go long, and the victory is his. Their confirmation, 21-18, 21-19. In 45 minutes.
Speaker of Mexico, at der er tre biler, der holder ulovligt parkeret ved vindområdet. Vi beder ejerne at fjerne dem omgående. Registreringsnummer er CF 20766. ID 28755. Og AT 83205. Tak.
So we turn our attention next to women's singles and the world number one, Saina Nawal, winner of the Denmark Open 3 years ago when she beat Juliana Schenk in the final. She's up against the Japanese player Minatsu Mitani. So three courts in action here in Odense. Well, the destination Dubai rankings as far as the women's singles is concerned. Well, the number one and two change places because Carolina Marin didn't play in the Korean Super Series, and nor did Saina Nawal. And both of them suffered. In fact, Saina Nawal went down two places. But of course, the winner from Korea, the home player, Sung Ji-hyung, came into the top 10, up from 13, up three places to number 10 on the Super Series standings. And of course, Wang Yi-han, the beaten finalist in Seoul, the last of the Super Series events, up two places from number 5. So there was a little bit of movement in the women's singles destination Dubai rankings. Interesting that Wang Shexian, number 1, but she hasn't won a Super Series title this year. Well, as we can see, Sung Ji-hyung, who won the Korean Super Series, has already booked her place in the quarterfinal, the number 7 seed. But who will she play? Will it be Saina Nawal, the number 1 seed, or Minatsu Mitani of Japan?